Welcome to today's session. As Brian Adams bragged about magical India, let's understand the real reasons behind the magic. Let's delve a little deeper into the issue of North Indian smog. Let's get started with the basics. What's happening? In Delhi and other parts of northern India, the air quality has started deteriorating and is expected to get worse as winter sets in and wind speed starts to drop. Why does this happen? Every year, in the month of October, farmers across Punjab, Haryana and Western UP set fire to tons of paddy straw, resulting in smoke. The smoke, arising out of stubble burning, combined with vehicular emissions, makes Delhi and surrounding areas' air deadly and difficult to breathe. How has the government responded? It banned the burning of crop residue and imposed heavy fines for violation. Centre approved a package to give subsidy to farmers to encourage mechanized removal of stubble. The conventional explanation for the Delhi smog is the burning of rice straw by the farmers of Punjab, Haryana and Western UP. Earlier, manual labourers were employed to harvest the crop, but nowadays the farmers use mechanical harvesters in order to cut, thresh and clean rice from paddy, which leaves 6 to 8 inch long straws on the field, which cannot be used as animal feed because of the high silica content. Further, the fields need to be prepared for the winter crop in 2 to 3 weeks time gap that leaves a short window of about 3 weeks between the harvesting of paddy and sowing of wheat. If there is a delay in the planting of wheat beyond the first week of November, then it will lead to lower yields. There are machines such as straw management systems and happy seeder that can take care of the straws, but machines cost money, whereas all that is needed to start a fire is a matchstick. In addition to this, the effigies of Ravana are also burnt on the day of Dasara in the month of October, which also contributes to the bad air quality. The conventional explanation does justify the smog, but there are other fundamental questions that need to be addressed, like why do semi-arid states like Punjab and Haryana grow rice in the first place? The Indian government primarily procures rice and wheat directly from farmers at minimum support price. Punjab contributes a whooping 27% share of the total rice procurement of the Indian government. This large procurement is a hangover from the days of the Green Revolution, where the government was trying to incentivize Punjab farmers to grow more food grains to make India sufficient on the food front. All the rice is being grown in semi-arid region, which ends up using a lot of water. Also, free electricity allows Punjab's farmers to pump all the groundwater they need. Like this, massive resources have been spent on promoting unsustainable farming patterns. Now let's try and understand the problem from the farmers' point of view. The farmers feel that city dwellers who keep adding new cars to Delhi are to be blamed. This is also true to an extent because certain apportionment studies which indicate the origin of the pollutants blame the vehicular emissions in Delhi for the problem. The farmers complain that after the government subsidies were announced, manufacturers quickly raised the prices of SMSs. When it comes to happy seeders, the farmers will need to use heavier and more powerful tractors to pull the seeder out, spending more on diesel and rent. There is an added concern that the wheat crop may be prone to fungal infection due to the decomposing straw. What can be the solution to this? Firstly, the free electricity being given at least to medium and large farmers should be done away with. Of course, given the strong lobby of large farmers in the state, this remains easier said than done. Secondly, the procurement of rice by the FCI has to move away from semi-arid areas like Punjab to more water-efficient areas like West Bengal and Assam, where it will take less water to grow rice. Third, the import duty on rice needs to come down because such a high level of import duty on a water-guzzling crop like rice is not desirable. If the import duty on rice is rationalized, it may support crop diversification into much-needed crops like oilseeds and pulses. Fourth, the excess procurement of rice in the central pool needs to end. As per stocking norms, as on 1st October, the total amount of rice that needs to be maintained in stock is at 10.25 metric ton. The actual stock is at 18.63 metric ton. Given that the government is buying more rice than it needs, it encourages the farmers to produce more rice. Delhi and North India's smog problem is about the allocation of right resources in the right areas. And given that, it is a political problem more than an economic one. Few model questions have been mentioned here. Try to write a 200 to 250 words answer for each of them. Thank you.